Welcome back. I'm Dr. Jim.
And I'm Dr. Janine.
And this is the next in our series of tests that you need done specifically for cardiovascular health and helping maybe even reverse something you may already have. And that's the HS, or high sensitivity C-reactive protein, or CRP.
Yeah, CRP is a protein that is made in the liver in response to inflammation. What does a CRP tell you? That's the big question. Well, there's a few things. One of the things you look at is cardiovascular, and that's kind of what we're talking about today, is how it affects the cardiovascular system. Well, if you have an inflammatory response going on in the arteries, the CRP can be elevated. It is not the only thing that can be elevated. Just because the CRP is normal does not mean you don't have a problem. But if it's elevated, you need to start looking. Now, the range on CRP, you have, you know, 0 to 1, which is your low risk for cardiovascular disease.
That's where you want to be.
Right. You have 1 to 3, which is average risk, but to me, it still shows something possibly could be going on.
They call it moderate risk.
Right, moderate risk. And then you have your above 3, which is a high risk. We hear a lot of times, well, C-reactive protein is not always an indicator of cardiovascular disease, and that is true.
True.
There are other things that can increase the C-reactive protein. Infection is one of the big ones.
Mm-hmm.
On an infection, that CRP will go to 40, 50, 200. I've seen it sky high. So the worse the infection, the higher the CRP. And bacterial infections actually increase it more than viral and fungal infections. So if you see an extremely high one, then it's probably more due to an infection. Cancer can also increase the C-reactive protein. Because if you think about it, anything that makes inflammation, infection is very inflammatory, cancer is very inflammatory, and of course, if you have something going on in the arteries. So that's when you have to have somebody kind of interpret it, kind of look and see what else is going on, make sure there's no other reason that it's elevated. But it just kind of points you in a direction that something could be wrong.
It is, you know, and we see a lot of people who fall in that range between 1 and 3, which is what they call average. And that's the moderate risk group. And if you want to be a moderate risk, okay, I guess if you're satisfied with that, I preferably would like to be in the low risk, which means less than 1. And so we'll explain it to the person if we do the test for the patient. That's how we explain it. You know, okay, you want to be, this is one time that you see a low value and you really want to be a low value.
Right.
You want as little inflammation as you can possibly have in your body.
Right. Low is definitely better when it comes to the C-reactive protein. Now, another thing that people might not think about doing a C-reactive protein for is I will do it on young girls on birth control. Because, yes, it's a risk. When we say cardiovascular risk, it's a risk for, of course, heart attack, but also for stroke. And birth control pills are known to have a stroke risk, and some more than others. So I usually, on someone on birth control, will recommend they do an hs-CRP. And if it is elevated, it looks like probably their birth control is increasing that stroke risk. Now, again, you know, it's their decision on what to do with the information, because some people refuse to get off of them. Some people say, oh my gosh, I don't want that risk. So I have people that the C-reactive protein have been elevated and it will not go down as long as they are on what's causing the risk.
Right.
We see a lot of just estrogens, not just birth control pill, but actually synthetic estrogens also increase that risk as well. So you can look at medications being the thing that increases inflammation and risk. You can think of infection. You can think of cancer. There's a lot of things that increase that value. Take all the values away. You know, okay, you know this person doesn't have cancer. You know they don't have an infection. They're not on any medication that can cause it. And then you see an elevated level. Then you know that it's probably a cardiovascular risk because of whatever else is going on. And you can correlate it with all the other testing. There's not just one test, and that's why we're doing this series where we talk about different tests.
Mm-hmm.
There's different tests, and you have to correlate and look at them as a whole. Just doing one test doesn't tell you, because you might have one person that their lipoprotein A could be low as could be, but they could still have cardiac risk because they have other factors going on. So that's kind of the way we approach things, is looking at the whole picture. If you do have a CRP that is cardiovascular, because that's what we're talking about today, is more of what to do when it's cardiovascular risk. When it's an infection, totally different. When it's, you know, those are totally different. When it's cardiovascular, what do you do to lower that CRP?
Right. And there's a lot of natural products that'll lower that C-reactive protein. If you've watched some of our other videos, I'm sure you've probably seen us talk a lot about Nattokinase. Nattokinase is great for helping lower C-reactive protein. So are the omega-3 fish oils, or actually the SPMs,
right,
are kind of a derivative of the fish oil. They're even better.
SPM by far is what I have seen over the years be the best thing for lowering that hs-CRP.
And
it really is.
We've literally looked at and tracked with serial testing. We've tracked hundreds and hundreds of patients. So we've seen that hs-CRP go down when they take those SPMs.
Oh, by far, I think it's the best in that you really, if you have a high CRP, you really should be on SPM Select.
Right.
Now, curcumin, we talk about curcumin, definitely can lower it as well. Red reishi extract definitely can lower it as well. So it look at some of the other parameters of risk factors can also help with the CRP as well.
Right.
Our Natto Advantage, which he mentioned, Natto, has serrapeptidase, which serrapeptidase is more for the inflammatory part as well. There's a lot that you can do to change it. You got to figure out, okay, if it's elevated, why is it elevated? And then, and that comes from all the other testing. And you just kind of look and then take something. And then what we always do is give it like 3 months and repeat the test. That's how you know if something's working. To me, if you repeat the test and it is not going down, something, you got to do something different. Either your diet has to change even more, or you have to figure out why it is not budging. Because that C-reactive protein is just an indication of something being wrong.
But it's a big indicator.
It is.
And it's one that you really want to pay attention to. Now, if you haven't had it done in the past, we highly suggest you getting it done. A lot of people to come in have had that CRP done, and it's a very good test.
You do CRP done more than some of the other testing. And like I said, it is definitely done even in hospital settings for infection. It can track whether the infection's getting better or not, whether as it's going down. So you kind of want to, it's more of an inflammatory response. It's definitely an inflammatory marker no matter what area it's in. So you want to get down inflammation. And so when you start talking about inflammation, like we said, our SPM, you know, you got curcumins, you got boswellia, you got, I mean, there's so many natural products, serrapeptidase, nattokinase, that actually help with inflammation. So that is an area that natural medicine does very good in, is helping with an inflammatory response. And all disease starts with inflammation.
All disease.
You have to get that CRP is not just important in cardiovascular disease. It's actually important for overall health. So you do want to find out your value. It is actually on our regular expanded cardiac panel, and it's on the super cardiac panel, and it's on our super panel. So it's on a few different panels. And of course, you can always add it separately to one of our other panels.
Okay. So you now you know what a hs-CRP is and how important it really is. And there know that there are some things you can do to change it. So hopefully you got something out of this series, and we'll have more to come in the future. So stay tuned.